Good morning, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us on this Saturday morning. For Racine and me, I'm Jessica Tai. The latest numbers show Racine County's unemployment level at 7.6%. The county saw a little improvement in 2013, but that number is still too high. There are many people in Racine County right now struggling to find a job. The good news is there's a company looking to hire more than 200 people. United Natural Foods Incorporated is opening up a new distribution center in Sturtevant and has major hiring events starting on Wednesday. The general manager of UNFI, Chet Hickok, and project manager Jeff Graham are joining us in the studio this morning. Thank you both for coming in today. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Jessica.
This is great news for a lot of people. We're going to get to the job opportunities in just a minute. But first, let's give people a little bit of background about your company. Tell us about UNFI and what you do.
UNFI is the largest distributor of natural and organic foods in the country. And that's our passion. We distribute natural and organic food products. That's what we do. So,
why is it also your passion?
Well, right from inception back in the 70s, our vendors have been connected to us, to our customers. We've all been together in growing the whole organic and natural food chain. So that's why it's fun working there, because it's more than just moving boxes. We're getting natural foods out into the general public and out to our customers.
Exactly. The organic and natural movement is really growing in popularity. Mm. What type of demand are you seeing?
Actually, the type of demand we're seeing is the type that's causing us to come to Wisconsin. There's been a growth in the demand really ever since our inception, but as we're getting bigger and bigger, that growth keeps getting more and more in need of more distribution centers and stuff. But it's growing at a double digit rate, as far as a percent growth rate.
Double digits.
That's the type of growth we've been seeing in our industry in recent times.
And we're part of that reason for that growth, Jessica, is because our grandmothers told us, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure, and you are what you eat, and all these things. And then you got the documentaries coming into play of Supersize Me and Food Inc. Mm-hmm. and Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead, and all those kinds of other documentaries that, even if a piece of it is true, you got to scratch your head saying, man, what am I putting into my body? And then the whole non-GMO project, all those things are coming to bear and are just really behind us. And really, we're leading in the industry in helping people to understand that what you eat is important.
Sometimes when it comes to foods, we see fads, but when it comes to organic and natural, it doesn't seem like a fad. I can't imagine this is going away anytime soon as far as the demand.
No, absolutely not. And I think that we were founded in 1976, and as a result of that, double digit growth forever since we've been in existence. And so I think that's proof that this is here to stay.
Yeah, and take a look at this video too. It's really interesting to see from the farm to the distribution center and out from there. Let's get local now for a moment. Why did United Natural Foods choose Sturtevant for its new distribution center?
Well, if you take a look at our customer base, we were servicing the Chicago metro area out of Iowa in Indianapolis. And so from a logistics perspective, it makes sense. But probably more important than that, the state of Wisconsin, Racine mm-hmm. County, Racine itself, the Economic Development Department in Racine, Sturtevant, they've all just been open arms to get us to come here. So it's been a marriage that's been very pleasant to this point in time.
And to go along with that, the village of Sturtevant has gone above and beyond, as well as Chet mentioned, Racine County, with the economic development folks and the workforce development people. Len Mackey and his team and Jenny Trick over at Economic Development have been phenomenal to work with, and the overwhelming support from the community has really been exciting to be a part of, and to see how excited people are to see us come and be a part of what you guys have got going here.
Most communities would love to have a new distribution center come to town. It means more jobs. There's always a ripple effect. Was there an incentive package to get you here?
Absolutely. There were a couple of aspects to that. One is the capital infrastructure piece, and also job creation tax incentives that were certainly generous, but also designed to help us attract the right people to the jobs.
Distribution center is at the corner of Highway 11 and Highway H. What is the construction process like? When will you actually open the doors and get people working inside?
It's coming along really well. We should be looking at occupancy sometime in the month of March. We'll actually start receiving groceries into the building in May, and we're going to be shipping out of there in June. So construction has been very good.
We've hired about 20 people to date, just in from the leadership standpoint, and a few people on the floor to help label racks and get the process up and running. So it looks good. We'll have to get you out there for a tour sometime.
That would be great. So 20 people already, but you have many more to go. Right off the bat, you're hiring about 220 people. We're going to talk a lot more about that coming up after the commercial break. But do you see room for growth as far as jobs, even after that, down the road?
I take that one. Yeah. We're coming in there with 220 people. That represents about 40% of the capacity of that building. And the building is built to expand more than double. So we're looking at the growth that we've had to this point in time with the company and projecting that out, and we're anticipating continued growth out of that site. So
one of the things we've done is when we purchased the work with the Village of Sturtevant to purchase the land, there's built-in expansion room there. And we've got a couple other new distribution centers coming up as well, one in Montgomery, New York, as well as Gilroy, California. And we're moving forward with all of these facilities having the room to expand, because we don't want to be landlocked and be 100% capacity, because then we run into some efficiency issues and some capital issues.
Yeah, sure. Smart business, thinking about the future. You got to do that. Thank you so much. Don't go far. We're talking about the hiring events next. If you don't need a job, share the information with someone who does, because there are a lot of people still looking for work in Racine County. Where the hiring events are happening and what you need to know to come out on top. That's next. UNFI is looking to hire more than 200 people for its new distribution center in Sturtevant. There are 6 hiring events over the next few months, all of them at the Fountain Banquet Hall in Sturtevant, and the first one is coming up on Wednesday. UNFI's general manager and project manager are back with us now to tell you everything you need to know to hopefully score a job. I know a lot of you are listening very carefully right now. You guys are looking, there are more than 20 different types of jobs. I know we can't get into all of them, but tell me maybe about some of the most important ones.
Right off the top, Jessica, the Class A CDL drivers are important for us. They're the face of our UNFI to our customer base, the ones that deliver the product from the DC to the customers. And supporting them, we've got the receivers to receive the product into the facility, and then also the selectors who actually select the product and build the pallets that go on the trailers to be delivered to the customers. And everything else is in support one way or another to them, to that end.
Okay. Tell me about some of the other ones. I know we can't get into all of them. Those are the most important ones, but...
You've got inventory control folks. You've got routers. You've got warehouse administration clerks to help the process along. Just several more. I could go on. Sanitation
workers.
Go on
and on. Yeah. That's wonderful. Well, hey, that's good news. What kind of experience do these people need?
For the warehouse positions, we're certainly looking for some people with experience, but if they don't have experience relative to working in a distribution center or a food distribution center or working with any of the automated voice pick systems or warehouse management operating systems, Manhattan is what we use. Those are all important, but just as important is a person's willingness and attitude to be a part of what's going on there and buy into the site vision and beliefs that Chet has put together for that facility. And
and probably to learn, too, just to be able to learn if you don't have that experience, to be a quick learner.
Absolutely, and thank you. And the pay rates differ from $13 to $17 per hour for those initial warehouse positions, depending on experience.
Okay, sounds good. That was one of my questions. People always want to know pay and benefits as well.
Absolutely. Benefits are just as important, and we have a great benefits program that kicks in after you've been with us for the first of the month following 90 days of employment. We have a wonderful 401k plan. Eligibility kicks in after 6 months of employment, where we match 50% up to the first 8% you contribute. Lots of other things go along with that. Just as important to the wages and benefits, though, is the culture inside the warehouse. We're separate or different from any employers in that regard, where we want to create a culture where people can thrive by being involved in what's going on there, being recognized for the work they do and having interesting work. It sounds mundane and maybe cliché-ish, but it's vital to being successful at work.
Oh, it is so important. It keeps morale up without a doubt. You're mentioning a little bit about the vision. When it comes to being an employer, who are you looking for? Who would you like in that distribution center as employees, as workers in Sturtevant?
Good employees. That's what we're looking
for. That's easy.
If you look at our heritage and our culture, the thing that drives us is our passion for natural foods. And that kind of permeates the whole, all of UNFI. You mentioned the benefits. One of our benefits is our employees get a 25% discount on natural foods.
Oh.
That brings in a lot of employees, just that. People that like natural foods, and they tend to work well in our environment. That's the type of employees that that we're looking for.
To add a little bit more to the good employee piece, demonstrated work ethic, things that it's really not rocket science. Yeah. The demonstrated work ethic is important. Reliability, dependability, responsibility, as evidenced in punctuality and attendance. You know, being open-minded to do things maybe a different way than what they've done things in the past. All those things are important to make a successful associate for us.
Yeah, combined with someone who believes in the product, I think that's the best bet. Mm-hmm. When, if hired, when will these people actually start working?
We're going to be hiring a group of people in mid-April to start receiving product into the plant. We actually start receiving in May, and we actually start shipping out of the building the second week in June. So
that'll be here before you know it, that's for
coming
sure.
Quick.
Absolutely.
What should job seekers bring to these hiring events?
Great question. A great attitude, that carries a lot. That first impression is vital. If you have a copy of your resume, you can bring that as well, electronic or paper. We prefer electronic to be uploaded to the system. We can certainly talk more about that if you like. The hiring events themselves, the ones on March 5th and 6th, will be conducted at the Fountain Hall in at 8505 Durand Avenue in Sturtevant. And I want to give thanks to Chuck Beth for donating his facility to us for this great event. He's very supportive of the community and UNFI. And it's just indicative of all the support we've received throughout the time we've been in, on the ground here.
And there's a way that people can speed up the process by going online first to your website. Show us that.
Absolutely. If you go to unfi.com, on the right-hand side, you've got the careers link. After you click it, you go to job opportunities. And from here, you'll have the opportunity to search for positions in Wisconsin. And once those come up, all of the available opportunities will come up. You find one you're interested in. I'll just pull up warehouse receiver. And you can apply here by touching on new resume CV. And even if somebody's already created a profile online, you still, we found that you have a greater success of getting it if you just click the new resume CV and go through that process.
That will speed it up. Well, that's
absolutely
great. Wonderful. I just want to recap here. So grab your pen and paper, because I know there are a lot of you who would like to go to these hiring events. There are six UNFI hiring events over the next few months. All of them are at the Fountain Banquet Hall on Durand Avenue in Sturtevant. They run from 9 a.m. until 8 p.m. on March 5th and 6th, so the first one coming up on Wednesday. Also April 9th and 10th and June 6th and 7th. Thank you both for coming in, and good luck with the new facility.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. Up next.
They encourage you and support you in what you're trying to accomplish. It's tough out there, and there's a lot of times when they give you that little extra push to keep going.
The most important tool, I think, is the way the people here help you get what you need, whether it's, you know, making a resume, whether it's finding a job, or, you know, all the tools that they provide that you could use towards, you know, attaining your goal.
With an unemployment rate above 7% in Racine County, many people are just like those men in need of work and looking for help. You could find help finding a job at the Racine County Workforce Development Center. Mark Mundell, the center's strategic coordinator, is joining us today to highlight some of the center's services. Thank you so much for coming in.
Good morning, Jessica. It's great to be with you.
There are so many services. I mean, we're talking about, looking at your website, more than 35 workshops that you have. Job skills, career advancement, training. Tell us about some of them.
I think one of our best workshops is on interviewing. We'll do a mock interview with you, and we'll also put you on videotape so you can observe your own actions during the interview, those little mistakes, and see how you can improve and impress that interview when you need to bring your A game.
I think that is so important. I recently talked with a young woman who was trying to get a job, and she continually gets called back, but she's not getting it. And I said, there's something. And so I had suggested that. Do you find that just people understand, okay, now I see?
Absolutely. You know, seeing is believing, and, you know, there's a lot of things. You just don't realize you're doing it, and you're not, you're setting yourself up. You're giving those nonverbal communications that are saying, oh, no, don't hire me. And that's really not what you're trying to message, and it's probably not really what you represent.
Hire me. I am the one to hire, right? As far as the resume, too, do you help building the resume? For some people, it's a piece of cake. Others don't really know where to start.
Well, certainly. We help you with start you with a foundation resume, and then we coach you on how to do it. Each job that you might be applying to needs a different resume. And with computer technology, you know, there's no reason for you not to change your resume to fit the job based upon your skills.
Cover letters, too. What do you suggest for cover letters?
Keep it short, keep it to the point, and you start with one. And probably more important than the cover letter, I think, is the thank you note, saying that if Jessica spent time interviewing me today, that your time was valuable, I'm still interested in working for CBS 58, and I'm really excited about the opportunity.
Exactly. So we talked about resumes, we talked about the cover letter and the interview. What other services and workshops do you have?
We offer a range of services from GED. If something happened, you chose not to graduate from high school, come on back, get your GED now. Opportunities for where your skills aren't going to be current and you need to upgrade those skills. I think in the next segment you're going to hear from a young man that decided to go into manufacturing and learn about our CNC bootcamp. Right now we have CNC bootcamp applications where we have a 90% placement rate in a manufacturing job that starts off between $12 and $14 an hour. And just a little secret here, we'll be releasing our second youth CNC boot applications next week. So young people that are juniors in high school, get out there, take a look. If you're not going to college, or if you're thinking about college, maybe it's not the right option for you. Here's an opportunity to try something really exciting.
90% placement, that's great, wonderful to hear. Also, computer training.
Certainly, we offer computer training from the basics of like, this is the mouse, and this is how you turn on your computer, and it won't bite you, to things such as the Microsoft Office from Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. You can come in the evening and learn at your own pace. So if you want to, if you got to get it done quickly, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you've learned the Microsoft Word basic. If you're busy, a little more like a lot of people, come in once a week and learn the skills.
And for some people, it sounds so silly because a lot of people, a lot of us are addicted to the computers or the iPads or the iPhones, but there are a lot of people out there too, maybe older people who didn't have to do that in their work before and now find themselves out of a job and need those skills.
Absolutely, and that's what we're there for. We're a community resource. We serve those from young people to older people, from those that have high school diplomas to people that have master's degrees.
And you are very busy right now, correct? How many people might you see in, say, a week or a month's time?
In a course of a week, we probably see about 1,000 customers.
How successful are you in helping these people?
Well, last year, members of my team were helpful with getting over 300 people jobs, moving them from unemployment to a new career and giving back to the community and things like that. It's phenomenal.
That's wonderful. Is there a fee for the services?
The fee, there is no fee with the services. These are funds that are supported by federal, state, and local dollars.
And you help businesses as well. It's not just job seekers, as we just saw with UNFI earlier.
Certainly, and to help the job seeker prepare for UNFI, UNFI likes the interview to be kind of like, it's a story. They use a specific technique called STAR, that's situation, task, action, and result. So we're going to train and we're going to prepare our job seekers to deliver the message to UNFI like UNFI likes to hear it.
You also have two different locations. Real quickly, let's go ahead and put those on the screen and tell me about the two different locations for people who would like to come and use your help.
Our main office is located in Taylor Avenue in Racine, and we're open Monday through Friday from 8 to 5. The computer skills workshops occur in the evening from 5 to 8, Monday through Thursday. And then in the western part of our county, we're at the Gateway Technical College on 496 McKenna Parkway. That's right next to the Burlington High School, and we're open Monday, Tuesday, Thursday from 9 to 4 p.m.
You have so many resources, so many services. We'll have to have you back because really this just skims it.
Well, thank you so much for having me this morning.
Thanks for coming. We appreciate it. Up next on Racine and Me, we'll meet two people who gained valuable experience through the Racine County Workforce Development Center. Hear their stories next. Welcome back, everyone. We just explained the services the Racine County Workforce Development Center provides for job seekers. Now here's proof that with your effort, they really do work. Dina Cucinato and Andrew Christian both got help at the Workforce Development Center and both are employed today. Thank you guys so much for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
Dina, I'm going to go ahead and start with you. You are a marketing specialist. Take me back to the time when you were unemployed and you needed some help.
6 years ago, or a year ago, I was laid off from a position, a community outreach and marketing position that I had for 6 years. And I hadn't had to look for a job in 6 years, so ProTech was recommended a year before I needed it, and it is a professional networking service that helps folks who are displaced or laid off get a job. So it's a professional networking group, and they also help you find a job. So in the beginning, first part of the workshop, people talk about the experiences they've had during the week looking for work. And then the second part of the workshop, two of the career professionals, they offer an educational piece to it, whether it's how to build a resume or how do you get references, prepping for an interview, whether it be a phone interview or a Skype interview or a face-to-face interview. And if you haven't had to look for a job for a while, some of these skills, you might be a little rusty. So it's really, it's a great workshop and it's a great program.
Did you feel what you learned through ProTech at the Workforce Development Center helped you get your job today?
Definitely. It definitely, because in 6 years, I mean, what employers are looking for in a resume, what they're looking for in an interview, again, if your skills are a little rusty, I think if you've been in a position for a number of years, you get kind of comfortable.
Sure.
So when you're out there looking for work, it gives you a little bit of an edge that you normally wouldn't have if you didn't know, like I said, what employers are looking for.
And now you do, for sure. Andrew, you work in manufacturing right now. You went through training at the Workforce Development Center. You went through a boot camp, so to speak. Tell me about that.
It was the first ever high school boot camp. They've ran 17 of them for adults so far. And then this was the first one offered for youth, and just a great opportunity to keep going on and get a career.
What did you actually learn through the boot camp?
Learned a lot of different things to help me with our job. Math, people skills, how to actually run the machines, various things.
When it comes to people skills, what exactly do you mean by that? What did they help you with?
I mean, how to actually communicate with people and get you, you know, what you want out of something, you know, that kind of thing.
Do you see yourself when you're at work? Do you think back to, I remember that from training? Are there ways that you can tell us, I learned this and I'm using that on a day-to-day basis at my job now?
Definitely. One of our instructors was big on cleaning up parts and making sure there was no, you know, burrs on them or chips or anything on them, and that's actually what I do at my job now. And I just, you know, remember him, okay, you got to do this and this and this to, you know, clean up the part really nice.
Between the two of you, at the end of the day, I think sometimes there's some people out there who maybe are embarrassed that they are unemployed and they don't necessarily want to go seek help. What would you say to those people?
I would say that you need to force yourself. Going to ProTech, we were just talking about that before we came on. When you get laid off, you're not really feeling so good about yourself, no matter what. And going to an organized group like this, it's a positive thing you can do. And the ladies that lead the group, they turn it into, so you got laid off, so maybe you can reinvent yourself. Maybe you can go after a career, a job that you've never even considered. So I encourage people to force yourself. It's Monday mornings from 9 till noon. It's a great way to start the week. It puts a positive spin on things. And they also provide a lot of handouts and information of employers looking to hire people and what those qualifications are. So there's a ton of resources as well.
Wonderful. Gives you a little spark to keep on going.
It does.
Thank you so much for coming on. We appreciate it to both of you. I do want to let you know, and maybe you're just joining us now, in case you missed it earlier, we started today's show talking about the job opportunities at United Natural Foods' new distribution center in Sturtevant. There are 6 hiring events over the next few months. All of them are at the Fountain Banquet Hall on Duran Avenue in Sturtevant. They run from 9 a.m. until 8 p.m. on March 5th and 6th, so starting this Wednesday, April 9th and 10th, and June 6th and 7th. So good luck if you go. Thanks so much for joining us, everyone. Join us next week for Racine and Me.